do that is just to let you know of this tool that is supposed to help you increase your organic growth and traffic. And as long as you're eligible to be on Discover, and I will take you through that, this should be something that's routing some traffic to you. So wanted to just give you an idea of Discover. Discover was earlier known as Feed. So it's essentially just a feed. I can't see my own presentation, Vaibhav. So I don't know. Have you started it? Are we on the first slide? What's going on? Karthik, Vaibhav, if anybody could let me know. It's working fine. Got it. We're on the first slide. Got it. Give me a bit. Let me open my slides on the side. Cool. So it's a feed. And the reason that we had come across this whole idea of, hey, let's come up with something like Discover, was that feeds are incredibly popular. And feeds were how most people were finding the information they wanted to see. And that was across platform, not just Google's. So this was Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, Gmail, people were constantly discovering information from feed. However, one thing that we noticed was that feeds were full of ads. And that was the key concern that we started to want to address. And we wanted a feed that's completely customizable, completely organic, and doesn't rely that much on ads. So can you get me to the next slide? And also, can you check for echoes? I think it might just be your mic, Vaibhav. Awesome. Thank you. So the channel, and like I said, it was mainly the fact there was a lot of ad loads on channels, be it TV, Facebook, etc. Let's get on the next slide quickly. Yeah. So the whole idea was, let's have an in-feed experience so that users can stay up to date only about things that they're interested in or things that our machine algorithms show that they might want to know at that point. At the end of the day, we have an understanding of people's intent due to search, due to YouTube, due to email. So we wanted to stitch together those insights and create the right feed for people. And that's how we looked at it. Can we go to the next slide? Awesome. So where is Discover? Discover is on your mobiles. Discover is not, as of right now, a desktop experience. And it is across Chrome browsers. And you will find it at multiple places when you're just having your regular mobile experience on Google products. The one interesting thing, can we go to the next slide? So the one interesting thing about Discover is that it's not just news. So a lot of people think Discover is news because that's what being surfaced to you basis your interest. But it's not just news. It could be news. And if you're writing the right content that people are interested in terms of news, you might be surfaced. But it also could be some information regarding your present context. Like if you have an upcoming trip or a travel reservation, basis your interests that you've been searching across, or basis your own personalized settings. We often have this thing that we call evergreen content. Evergreen content, for example, in this slide is how to play a guitar. Now that's not news at all. But it's still content that a person might be interested in that point of time in their life. So it has a longer shelf life as created content. Can we go to the next slide? Yeah. Discover, as of late 2019, had 800 million MAUs. MAUs are monthly active users. So this is not a statistic that tells you about who's viewing Discover every day, or it's not to say that Discover has 800 million users. It just means that in terms of active users in a month, we clock at about 800 million in the Discover feed only. So it's definitely an interesting place to be if you're looking for users for your content. When it comes to Discover, people have come to us or often written about how they have improved their SEO by ensuring that they are on Discover. And I'll talk a little bit about that later. And people have seen as much as getting only 3.6 million impressions just basis Discover. And it seems to be pretty much everyone. And here you can see that we are getting a lot of positive information on Discover. So we do think this product is something that websites can use to ensure that they're organically visible to their key audience. I want to be on the slide that says optimize for Discover. All right. So now how to be on Discover. Discover is algorithmic and it is bases a lot of factors, but mainly it's posting content that you think users will find interesting. And it's basically matching the article's content and users' interest. So there's no way to climb up on rankings of Discover or to say, hey, I'm making so many efforts on Discover, my friend can't see this article on their Discover feed. It would not work like that. There is no ranking. It's just all algorithmically matching the user to content, and ranking could be very, very different for each and every user. So that's something to remember when you're making efforts towards Discover. But there are a few things that you can do. Can I be on the next slide for optimization, please? Okay. So these few things are, A, of course, post content that you think your audience would find interesting, which would also mean current content, which is why Discover is often linked to news. The second bit of things would be to follow Google's webmaster guidelines. This would even be those little warnings that you get that are not quite at that moment something that is urgent. But I would urge you to look at take every warning on webmaster seriously and ensure the guidelines. Ensure that your pages are, if your pages are indexed by Google, and if they meet policies, regardless of whether that's news content or not, because that's mainly policies to ensure there's no fake news, etc. As those two things are happening, you can just read the Google News for content policies, ensure this there, your page, if it's indexed and you meet the Google Webmaster guidelines, you should be on Discover. On somebody's Discover, even if not on your own. And the last thing that is a good to have is high quality images. We've seen that people see a higher CTR with high quality images, which are at least 1200 pixels. And in order for these high quality images to be visible, just ensure that either you're using AMP seems to be a very beneficial tool on Discover. And ensure that if you're not using AMP, then there is a form that you can access using the Google Help Center to express your interest in the opt-in program. And why we need this is that we need to have the right to display a high-quality image. So those are the few things that you can do to ensure that you are making use of these 800 million users, which is growing on a month-on-month basis. And it would just give you this additional push for your content. So that's pretty much it from my end. I'd love to know whether there any questions from you guys that I can address before I pass it on to Vaibhav from the Readwhere team to kind of take you through the nitty-gritties of where to find my Discover traffic, where do I see in Webmaster, whether I'm getting anything from Discover at all, and how can I optimize for Discover. Let the channel partner take care of that, and Vaibhav will do that. But if you have any questions for me, please go ahead and shoot.
Yeah, so if there are any questions, you can probably write it in the chat box, which is there on the right of the video or at the bottom of the video.
Cool.
Questions as such, Ishita, I think you were absolutely clear. We'll move to Vaibhav to take over. And once again, many thanks to Ishita for those for that data. I think the image you showed on Discover looks amazing, and I think everybody should be really excited about those numbers.
Yeah, it's still early days for this platform. So the data is only going to get more interesting with time by the looks of it, by looking at the present data. So I'm glad you guys are excited about Discover. And I'm going to now pass it on to Vaibhav.
So there are a couple of questions which...
Oh, okay.
First question is, does structured data play an important role in Discover? I think that's something to take care of.
Yeah. Also, the answer is, the answer is yes, because you have to be, you have to follow Webmaster guidelines completely. So it definitely helps to be indexed well, to be, but I'm sure your team will take care of the nitty gritty of this.
Yeah, and then a few other questions coming through. I think all of these questions will be taken care of as Vaibhav starts ahead. So we'll park these questions and come back to it later.
I do see a question around evergreen content. Is that, am I reading this right?
I think I read that too. That doesn't seem to be clear. So Nilesh, I think that's a question from Nilesh More. Nilesh, if you can just be a little bit more clear on the question, we'll take it up later.
Cool. So as of right now, I'm handing it off to Webhub.
Thanks, Ishita. Just having a small mic check. Am I audible to everyone? Great. So, am I audible to just having a small mic check? Am I audible? Yes, great. So, thanks, Ishita. So in last few slides, Ishita has mostly summed up all the best practices of Google Discover and how few best practices can really help us to enrich our pages and make them more visible in the Google Discover feed. And these are all the topics which we'll covering next few slides. Actually, they are not few slides. I have tried to keep them at minimum, but there is so much of it that I wanted to share with everyone. So let's start with that. So initially, we will be discussing what are the best practices which we should follow inside our pages, whether they are AMP or PWA. What are the best practices which we can use? Those are very common, but small nitty-gritties, which Ishita mentioned, can be added to them, which will make them more rich, which will make them more Discover friendly. Great. So this is already been covered, and I just wanted to explain a little more on this. That in case, and this is a no-brainer actually. We have to create useful and interesting content for our viewers and for our for our viewership who is reading our content on their phones or their desktops. Useful content and interesting content has always been a good factor, important factor since the beginning of the web, right? You write some good content, it will be visible to your users either via search console, either via social channels, or either via any reference which we see inside our analytics. So when you create useful and interesting content, it directly connects directly to your database, to your user base. People find interesting contents, they tap on your card, they read your card, and beside that card, they found that this particular publisher or this particular author is providing an amazing and useful content which we can, which we can keep on reading over a longer period of time. This interesting and useful content can be again, broadly classified into many ways. It can be about latest news, it can be about entertainment, it can be about hobbies. So in last few slides, you see there was a card of how to learn to play guitar. It's evergreen content which is never going to get old. There might be new songs, new medleys which you can add to that particular thread, and you can add them as a related news. That section we'll cover in the coming slides. But creating useful and interesting content is again one of the best measures which will directly help us to land your pages inside Google Discover, along with a few other measures. And we are not just leaving you that by saying just make useful content or just create useful content from somewhere. We all know that in today's world, trends, data, calculated data, calculated content is of major importance. And there are lots and lots of tools which can help you out in helping you what content is trending right now, what content you should plan, what content you should write, what are the tags we should use, and along with all the important tags, important modules you want to use, important entities you want to place inside your content. One of the best tools which we have reviewed so far, and it has helped many publishers, whether they are from English language, they are publishing in Hindi language, or they are on vernacular as well. Google Trends is a tool which help you to find out what particular news and topics are trending in what part of the world. So whether you are sitting in a remote area of a state in India, or whether you are sitting in a big city like Delhi, New York, and any bigger place. So these trends really help us to understand what exactly the people are searching, what exactly trends which are coming inside the Google searches, because these trends are directly helpful to the publishers on what content they want to write. So you can go and search for Google Trends. The home screen of this tools look like this. You can search for a topic and term in case you already decided on what content you want to write. In case you want help on what contents you have to write, let's say for Mother's Day coming in the next month, I'm searching for Mother's Day. For this, I can get what are the related topics on which I can write. What are the related queries on Google Trends that Google is receiving from the users all around the globe. And related queries can be tricky, right? So I'm just taking a small case. Like if I want to write an article about Mother's Day, I'll cover the content which is already in my mind. When it comes to tags, when it comes to keywords, I'll include very generic keywords like Mother's Day, 8th May, or any specific keyword which is which can be in English or which can be in any vernacular language as well. But the queries that come, those can really help you to take your page up inside the rankings. If the exact word of the query which is being searched on Google or which is being searched on a broader platform worldwide, can help your page to bring that up in the search listing. So related queries can be which are searched by users are a little bit on a practical side, right? So as you can see on the screen, you can see the related queries is a mixture of English and Hindi. So people are searching for Mother's Day message in English. Mother's Day kab aata hai? Mother's Day kab hai? I'm not saying please include these exact words inside your articles. Do analyze them. See what keyword make more sense according to your content. But please have a look at what queries and what trends are going on for the particular topic. Include those words and keywords inside your pages. Those will really help you. I can say those can directly help you to bring your content up inside the search listing. You can also see what are the rising and top trends, what are the keywords you find which are which are more usable and which are more compatible with your content. Based on that, you can include those keywords inside your meta keywords, inside your schema, inside your content in between. You can use LSI keywords in between your content. So these keywords can really help you. These terms, these queries can help you decide what content to write, what tags to include, what keywords you can add to your pages. Moving on to the next slide, some best practices which we are discussing right now is what makes pages more compatible to the Google Discover feed. Now, this is a very, overused, and most of the people who are very familiar with this is HTTP security. You can use this, you have to make sure the pages you are hosting on your AMP or on your PWA or on your website, make sure that those pages are on HTTPS. Because HTTPS gives a standard to all the pages that the particular page which is being served to you is being coming from a secure channel. And this is one of the highest best practice which you can use for all of your pages, whether they are AMP compatible, they are PWA compatible, whether you want them to be on Google Discover or not. HTTPS is a basic level security measure that you have to keep. And again, that's why it is included inside the Google Discover baseline checklist. See, the reason why these things are added inside the best practices is because it's very common. If your page is not secured via a standard service, the page can be hacked. The information which you're serving to users can be manipulated. So that's why these small checklists are baselines, and they add up a huge impact on your user base. Now, the whole the structure of the pages, the whole structure of Google Discover calculating the interests, is based on EAT model. So EAT model is expertise, authority, trustworthiness. And if you follow this EAT model, I'm pretty sure the content which you are writing, the content which you are providing to your users will be easily discovered, not just in the Google Discover part, but it will help you increase directly your organic traffic as well. So I'll just explain three points of expertise, authority, and trustworthiness. Expertise goes for, break the expertise into two basic type of concepts which are there. First is formal expertise. Formal expertise is if you're writing any content, you must be expert in that particular field. So for example, if you're publishing any news, the author or the journalist or the person who is covering that news must be expert in his domain. Formal expertise is everyday expertise. Formal expertise can be like if you're writing a content about how to make arar ki dal or how to make any specific dish. So that comes to everyday expertise. So these both things can be covered in expertise, but make sure you add the name of your author, which is there, you add a particular credentials to that, to your author part. Second is authority. Authority refers to the credentials and the reputation. So in some ways you can see the content creators, there are lots of bloggers and there are lots of big publishing houses as well who have a huge user base of the people who are reading their news, and they trust your channel, they trust your publishing house, they trust that whatever news you are giving to them, it is genuine. So for that, make sure you include proofs. For example, if you are covering any political news, you are covering anything on, let's say, a big coronavirus, which is affecting all of us right now. So if you're following a thread, please include any tweets or any embeds or any Facebook post or any notice or anything on which you are covering that news. Please include that proof inside your article so that it will add a check of authority on your content. And all these two factors brings the trustworthiness. We have already covered HTTPS. HTTPS is when you are serving your content on a secure channel. So that way we are already giving the users a trustworthiness factor that we are serving the content via HTTPS. So that means you can trust us, you can trust the delivery of the content. And we are already covered on the two parts above, like we are giving you the expertise in the particular format and we are giving you the authority or whatever content we are publishing. Also, if you are this is for all the news and media publishers, in case you are also publishing it or any e-commerce media sites, or if you are selling any news, or you have a paid model, then please make sure that you give the price of whatever article you are selling or asking people to subscribe on the upfront, and make sure you add those your policies inside your privacy policy section. Make a privacy policy page if it's not there in your website right now, and please add all these things. If you're even saving cookies, please take the permission from the users that we are saving cookies. It's okay. Everybody knows that sites save cookies, local cookies on the browsers, just to give them more personalized data. Next is use high quality images and videos. And this is again a no-brainer. If you use high quality images and videos inside your content, your content will be more liked than other cards which are coming. So I'm taking a very small example. You are there on your Google Discover screen, and there are two kind of cards which come there. One is a big card that comes in a very beautiful full width layout with at least 200 pixel height of the card. And the second card is the listing cards, where you can see it comes in a listing format, a very small square image which will be coming on the left hand side or the right hand side of the card, and there's a title coming above there. So as a generic user, and this I've been getting this idea from lots of people which I've talked to and which I interact to lots of publishers as well, the user is more tempted to click on the card which is having a high quality image or which is having a high quality video thumbnail coming out there. This is because, it's very simple. Images attract eyeballs more than the text. And unless the news which is coming inside the listing is very, very much important to the user or very relevant to the user will automatically go to the card which is having high quality image. So please use good quality images inside your content. And it's not that hard to make. There are lots and lots of websites available if you're using evergreen content. And also if you're covering news, please use high quality images. The standard size of the images which has been given by Google inside their standard policies is at least use the image which is 1200 pixels wide. And we have experimented and we have not actually experimented, we have done an A/B testing on our blog, on the blog we power for lots and lots of users. We have seen if we are using a fixed size image of 1200 by 900 pixels, and we are giving this size inside our schema data that we are using this size of image, this is the width, this is the height, and the image is actually a HD quality or high quality image. We have seen our CTR has improved on our pages, on our Discover pages a lot. And you can view these metrics and you can measure these all these things inside your webmaster's account, which we'll be covering in next slides. Now, this is again, this is a very no-brainer. Please make your pages indexable. Don't use any experimental tags like no index, or don't use any header meta tags inside your page, which will block users. Sorry, which will block crawlers to crawl your page and give your listing to discover feeds. Please don't use any meta tags. We have seen lots of WordPress publishers who use third-party plugins, which are not trusted. We see that when they make any update, lots of wrong code gets added inside their pages. So if you're using if you are updating any plugin, or if you are using such kind of third-party plugins, please keep a check on your pages. Please keep a check on the updates. Every plugin which get updates, they send you the list of checks and lists of improvements which they have done inside the new code release. Read that and please make sure that it doesn't affect your pages. Now let's get to the measurement part, and that's the part I most love, because everything these the slides which I have covered in the previous few slides, those are mostly very broad level data, but when it comes to numbers, the numbers never lie. So here webmasters allow you to give all the details of all the numbers, all the measurements you can have on your Discover traffic control. And here you can see how many pages are actually getting indexed inside the Google Discover part, how many pages you are who are not getting discovered, even though you have placed useful content on that as well. So first and foremost is, if you are using AMP pages, and if you are not, please start using AMP pages. Keep your AMP pages error free or warning free. So as you see in the screenshot which is there on the screen, few publishers which we handle on our part, we try to keep their pages error free and also warning free. So warnings can also sometimes help your content to warnings can make your pages to go below inside the Discover feed listing or in the organic listing, because warnings usually came with the like your image which you're using inside your page is not of a particular height, or it's not of a good strength or of a good quality that we can display a card. Or in schema, we usually have a image height and width measure, where we give that this is the height of the image and this is the width of the image, where the number can be different and actual height and width of the image can be different. So these warnings can affect a page performance. So please make sure you keep a check on your AMP pages. We have seen that lots of publishers came to us that we are facing a lot of difficulties inside our organic traffic. And we see that there are lots and lots of AMP errors which are there inside their webmasters. Usually we don't follow these things, because we see the pages which are coming in trending searches are fine. But keeping in check on your AMP pages is the most important thing which we can do right now. It can help you to go in multi-direction. It can help you to increase your organic traffic, and it directly can help you to get your pages inside Google Discover as well. Now, getting to the basic of performance of Google Discover. So whenever you logged into your webmaster control, on the left-hand side, there are lots of menus which are available. Fourth from the top is Google Discover. When you click on this menu, on the right hand side, you can see a full dashboard of the performance of all your pages. These graphs you can see here. These graphs gives you an idea of how many total impressions your pages are giving. Impressions is how many cards of your pages are coming inside people's Google Discover feed. And total clicks give you how many clicks are happening actually on all those pages. So here you can see that in this particular dashboard, we see that around 217 million total impressions we have done in a particular period of time. That is from November to March, which we are covering up. This is the data of one of our publishers. I cannot reveal the name here. But on that, we have received around 16.5 million clicks, and we have an average CTR of 7.6%. It's on an average, it's a good CTR, but we are constantly in touch with publishers to make this CTR way above than it is right now. So from this dashboard, you can see what pages what were the pages which are directly coming inside the Google Discover in the tabbing below. You can also measure them geographically, like in what countries your people are seeing your pages. What are the Discover appearances? In Discover appearance, you can see what kind of pages of your site are coming inside Google Discover. Whether those are AMP pages which are coming in Google Discover or your normal web pages which are coming in Discover. It's not a compulsion that only AMP pages come in Discover. Normal web, mobile web pages can also come in Discover, but it's always a best practice to provide your AMP page with all the data so that AMP page can come in there, and because AMP page is way more faster in various senses than a normal web page, and it gives you good returns revenue wise as well. So from the Discover appearance, you can see what all pages are coming, and if you see that some of the pages whose AMP pages are not able to get on Discover, just see that whether those AMP pages are not having any errors, and if they are having any errors, please rectify that and resubmit them inside your sitemap, or you can also manually submit them inside your webmasters. So these are the listing of the pages which we discussed. You can see these pages are directly coming in inside your Google Discover. These are the URLs of the pages you can see. Next topic which we'll be covering is structured data. So structured data has played an important role in structuring the whole web in last, 2 years. We have started working on PWAs and AMP from last two and a half years. We kept a major focus on structured data. People earlier used to place lots and lots of content, lots and lots of keywords inside their meta tags, and those are still useful. But structured data is the new meta, which you can say that. And this has been going on from a very long time. Crawlers directly go to the structured data part of your page. They see all the small snippets of whatever data you want to place inside your schema, and based on that data, they populate your search. The search can be in the form of a card, it can be form of an AMP card, or it can be again in a form of a Discover card. So please make sure that you keep a check on your structured data which you are placing inside your pages. We see a lot of errors sometimes comes in structured data, and that is because of the content. So structured data is basically a JSON type data which is there inside your page. I'm pretty sure most of you are aware of that. So sometimes if a special character comes in between, or sometimes a quotes or double quotes come in between, that small thing breaks up the whole structured data layout of your page. And that way, if it's like that, when the crawler comes to your page, it won't be able to get the whole information which it needs from your page. And if the whole information is not there, again, there will be no population, there will be no card generated for that particular article. So please make sure that you keep a check on the possible structured data errors. You can see all these errors again on the left hand side menu of your card. Please make sure you remove all these errors, and in case you have any difficulty, please reach out to us. I will be sharing my credentials in the last slide, and you can write us a mail and we'll raise a ticket for you, and we'll definitely help you in case you are feeling anything, any difficulty inside your structured data or any issues related to Google Discover. So this is just an example of structured data. So which we discussed in the last slide, how this small snippet covers the gist of your whole page. So it starts with what type of article you are publishing. So again, article types can be broadly categorized into 4 or 5 types. Here we are covering news article. You can add main entity of your page. You can add in what language your page in. So language helps a lot. So if a user is a vernacular user and he reads lots and lots of content on his vernacular language, this schema data can help you a lot with this. So one example which I wanted to share, we onboarded a very big publisher from West Bengal. So earlier they were using AMP pages through a WordPress plugin, and they were generating this structured data, which is a default feature inside the WordPress plugin. And their pages were doing fine. There was no error which was there inside their pages, and everything was fine. The pages which were getting generated via WordPress were up to the mark. But they were seeing that their pages are not coming, was not coming either in Discover, or they were not coming coming up inside the searches as well. So we debug like what can the issue can be inside their pages, and we found a very small hole in their content is their language is set to English only. So whatever content they were publishing in Bangla, but their in language was set to English. So that was one of the reasons that the people who are actually interested and they have their language set to Bangla in their preferences, they were not receiving their cards because the crawler was putting their pages inside the English bucket. So these small things which we can improve on structured data can really help us to make our page more visible to a more focused audience which you want to have. There are lots and lots of fields inside this schema LDJSON structure. These are most of the widely used fields which we use. There are also other more advanced fields which you can add to that, which I will be covering in a few slides after. The whole structure can be discovered into if you are publishing a review, you are publishing a book review, you are writing an article on a local store, on a local restaurant, or you are reviewing a book or anything. So this structured data varies according to the content. Now, in this slide, which we discussed in the last slide, that we can break down the content and we can break down the schema structure as well based on what type of article we are publishing. So broadly, articles can be categorized into five broad structures. First can be news article. This is one of the most broadly used structure because all over the publishers, news and media publishers around the world use news and article type structure data inside their pages. Second is movie reviews. Second is movies. So in movies, there are lots of other fields which we can add to this review. You can add rating. You can add who's the reviewer. You can add how many stars that particular movie get. The total number of stars. Who's the director? Who are the actors? And who is the producer? All these things. See, the more data you add to your schema, the more permutation and combinations will be there to get your page added to people's interest. Ishita already explained in the few slides that people get or generate their Google generate their Discover feeds based on what kind of interest those user have. So, for example, I am very keen to review to see the movies which are having good reviews. So I usually visit lots and lots of websites who publish the review of a particular movie, and based on that I decide whether I want to watch the movie or not. So if I add all these movies data like actors, directors, more and more data is getting available to the crawler, and based on that it can make more and more permutation combinations, and based on that your page can come to their interest list. Same goes with books, same goes with the products, same goes with the local business. If you are reviewing or writing any articles on that, please make sure that you add these extra structures in your pages. In case you are not able to do that, you are not finding good tools to do that, please let us know. Drop a mail to us. We will definitely help you to create different structures for different data types, for article types. And I'm pretty sure, and I'm absolutely sure, that this will help you to get your pages up in organic and in discovered searches as well. Third is you have already made a page, you have done your homework, you have made a page you know, more interactive, you have added that content which is very much interactive. But please make sure that the people who are you know, reading that particular article, they are not just reading that article and going back. Please make sure they are interacting with your article. Add embeds, add videos, add more engagement in your post, like add a comment section. If you're writing any movie review, add a comment section that if you have watched this movie, do you like it? Are you satisfied with our you know, review? Or is there anything you want us to cover in next movie review? If you are writing any news article, open that to comment. Ask people to share that article on your on their feeds, on their Twitter feeds, on the Facebook feeds, on any third-party platform. That way, the people are interacting with your content, and interaction is very much important as an interest list. We have already discussed the EAT model. We can see that when people are interacting or searching with your content, they are reading the content, they are commenting on the content, they are sharing the content. That means the user is genuinely interested in your article. That's why he is adding his value to your particular page. So make sure that you add certain elements in your page which you know, which enable users to interact with your content, whether it can be comments, it can be feeds, it can be shares. And these small things help us will help your page to get into the discover interest list of your user. Next is A/B testing. So see, we are after seeing all these things, I'm pretty sure lots of you are you know, making certain plans in their mind that we have to start using this inside our page, inside our website, or inside our pages. And most of you must be having some doubts as well. So where do we start? What should be the first step? Where do we start? So I guess in this, A/B testing can be a huge you know, help to you in this. Start creating some categories where you can see that you can start applying all these best practices which we have discussed in earlier slides. Create an A/B testing rule inside your analytics. See the pages which are publishing inside A section or B section, whatever section you allocate to Google Discover or organic traffic. See what kind of results you are getting in two different sections. Divide your content into topics and subtopics and track those metrics, like whether the pages where you are adding all these best practices are giving you better yield or better clicks or better traffic reach, organic reach, or discover reach. And I'm absolutely sure on the pages you'll be adding all these best practices will be giving you way better reach, way better results than the other one. And gradually you can transform your whole site. You can start using this these best practices along all your mobile web and all your AMP as well. And in case you feel anything, any platform dependency where you see that we are not able to do that, you can get in touch with us. We can help you directly with your platform, or we can help you with our platform, where we can enable all these best practices in a go. One more thing, while we are on the Google Discover part, this is a very practical thing which we can do. So most of the pages which we get in Google Discover are AMP pages, and even there, those are not AMP pages. Please try to make them AMP, because AMP has a better performance and gives better results than normal web pages. So whatever pages you are using, please try to add these small pop-ups, like at-home screen feature, which you can enable in your web or AMP. So for example, a user came to your website first time through Google Discover, and this has happened to me as well. I have discovered amazing websites from Google Discover. Lots of SEO articles I'm getting from new blogs. I've started following lots of followers on Medium, lots of writer on Medium, because Discover gives me and keeps on populating the content to me, and the content which I find useful, the content which I spend too much of time. So if you add these small features, and these features will give you a big results if in an overall growth. So if I landed on a site which is very new to me, and if the article, if the particular content is very useful to me, I'll browse 2-3 more pages, and I see if a user sees that there's a EAT factor inside this site, I'll probably add that site to my home screen. So this can be really useful for building a customer base of the returning users. So all the users which are coming to your website first time or second time or third another time to your website or your web AMP pages, please make sure that you add a web app manifest inside your AMP or PWA, where this manifest will help to populate a add to home screen banner. You can customize this banner as well. There are lots of documentation which is available, and you can write down whatever message you want to give to your user, that please add to home screen for SEO updates or news updates or food updates or music updates or anything. So this way user will add your site to your home screen, your returning user base increases rapidly. Also, if possible, please add service workers features inside your web or AMP. This way, this can help in two ways. First of all, if the user is not on a very well internet connection, it can help them to. It will help you to display offline pages as well. And also, if you want that particular user to jump to your other pages as well. So for example, if you're placing some related stories links, or if you're placing some other stories link inside your pages or in between your pages, which you should, then user will land on other pages, your service worker will get warmed up, and the next page which you want user to jump to will open more rapidly. So this will add a huge impact on the user experience, and when users see that this particular site provides a good user experience, that adds a additional value to the EAT trustworthiness model. So major takeaways which are there is get ranked high in SEO, use all the best practices which you have discussed in last few slides. If possible, please run promoted content campaigns and get engagement. Run few campaigns on social media, run few campaigns on Google Ads, run few campaigns on emails. Send out content in email newsletters. If you have a good customer database, please send them email newsletters. If people are opening any particular news via email newsletters, that means they are having their interest inside that. So that particular site will be added inside their interest list. And promote your content. Make sure if you're writing such amazing content, and all the publishers which are working with us and others as well, I'm pretty sure you're putting lots and lots of effort in writing your content. So please make sure you promote that. And reach new audience. Once you start reaching new audience, you will be getting added to their interest list, and your pages will start coming inside the Google Discover. So I guess we can take a small halt and take few questions which are coming in. So I'm getting lots of messages in the background with the questions coming in. So I'm taking a few questions. Okay. So, I guess we got one question from textile value chain. Is a difference between AMP and Discover? So this is a very huge difference. Discover is is a platform where you can see new content. AMP is an article or a web module. So for example, you must be having a website of your own, right? So if that website is must be currently in HTML, or you must be using a particular technology for the same. So AMP is a advanced format of the of delivering the content to the users on web. AMP uses lots of advanced modules, and those modules are very, very useful for Google organic search listings. And directly or indirectly, AMP help us help users or help your content to you know, get more availability to the users. It opens up your page, web pages really fast, because your AMP page are mostly cached on the Google side. So if someone is searching for any particular article, it will can be brought up in the organic listing. Couple more questions. So Udayavani has one question, is that we are using Kannada language in our news content. How to do SEO for it? Team Udayavani, SEO practices are very common for all the vernacular languages which you use. There can be few checks and balances which you can add inside your pages. So, for example, we discussed about what are the trends that people search for. So, you can search for trends which are happening in Kannada language, or you can see what search is happening in Bangalore or Karnataka area, that people are either searching them in Kannada or they are searching them in English. So, for any content type, you see that people are searching more in English. Please use English keywords inside your meta title, meta keywords, and add those. Please make sure that you add your keywords in the schema data. Other parameters can be as usual, but few things which you can keep in English. Try to keep that in English. For example, if you have a URL structure which is coming in Kannada, please have a A/B testing round. Make sure that your URL structure is in English. So that way, URL structure will help organic search listing a lot. It will help in populating the article, but it will not affect any way to the content. Content will be in full Kannada. So, and whatever the schema data you are using, make sure you add your in language as Kannada, or in article which you are publishing in English, tag them in English in language. You can use keywords and meta keywords, description as well. You can add some trending searches and keywords inside your schema, meta keywords. Other things which you follow can be very similar to what are basic SEO practices. Second is Mr. Dulari Yadav. Is local story do well on Google Discover? Yes, Mr. Yadav. Google Discover is a platform which deliver you news based on the interest which you have. It really doesn't make any difference whether that news is of a local domain or it's of a country or a state or a world. If I am interested in something which is happening around me, that and you are publishing that news and you are providing all the checks in your pages, like you're providing all the keywords, you're providing the data inside description, that article will come to me. It's global thing is nowhere related to Discover. It's very much related to what interest the users are having. So, for example, I am very much interested in some SEO articles. I am very much interested in new technologies. I am very much interested in the new trends which are going on the web right now. So, I get all the articles for that. I am interested in new music. So, I get all the music articles. Even I get local articles of, I live in Gurgaon, so I get local articles of Haryanvi Ragini, which is there on YouTube. So it's nowhere related to global or local news. It's very much related to what interest and what interest group your user base has. Next question we are having is from Mr. Anirudh Gohil. How to promote content as you mentioned lastly? So, Mr. Anirudh, this is a very broad field. And if I start, on this, I'm pretty sure I'll be taking more than half an hour of everyone on this call. So I'll make it brief. There are lots of channels of promoting it. One of the best and oldest use is sending email newsletters. Please make sure you get something, some credentials from your users. You capture their email IDs or you ask for their email IDs. Ask them to subscribe to your news, because and this has been mentioned on various blogs and one in the best practices as well. The news which we open from our email base is the most interested news, because there are lots of mail which we get daily. And if I'm opening up a mail distinctly, that means I'm having interest inside that. Apart from that, if you're not there, if you're not able to do that, please use promoting content on Twitter, on Facebook, on third-party platforms. So that way new user discovers your content, they open your article inside their browsers, and that way your site is getting added to their interest list. And make sure that you add some interactive parameters on your page, so that if you're spending money on promoting, you must get some output from there. And there can be other promoting platforms. If you're not using a PWA, please use a PWA so that you can send push notifications to your users, so that you can make them interact with your content again and again. So I guess you can connect to us, connect to me parallelly on this, and we can have a broad discussion on how to promote your content. I will be more than happy to discuss over this. I love discussing all these things. So next question is getting from Vignesh. What is the difference between AMP and video on the webmaster's tools? So Vignesh, AMP and video are parent and child entities, actually. So on webmaster, your AMP section, when you click on AMP section, it gives you a broad overview of all your AMP pages. It gives you a dashboard back performance of all your pages. So whether you're getting some errors, whether you're getting some structured data errors, whether you're getting any warnings or anything. Videos on a parallel part gives you information about the articles in which you're using any videos. So for example, if you search for your term inside Google Discover, inside Google search, you can see that lots of cards came in, and a card carousel comes as the first listing of the search. There you can see that some cards are having static images and some cards are having videos as their thumbnails. So that video which is coming inside their thumbnails is coming from the structured data which you have added there. So in there you have added that there is a media element present in my article. Please use this media element as a snippet of my article whenever you are making a card. So those media element, that media element is, that's a video, that video section description is there inside that webmaster video portal dashboard. So there you can see that whether people are clicking on your videos, how many playbacks has been happened over there, or the structured data which you have mentioned for the video, is that correct, or is there anything which needs to be added over there? So for example, we have a big publisher, Sanjeev Kapoor. So Sanjeev Kapoor is a very big chef, I guess everybody is aware of that. So they publish lots and lots of video content, like how to make this particular recipe. And with that video content, we add lots and lots of metadata to it, like what is the length of this video, what are the tags which are used in this video, what are the ingredients which we are using inside that video, or what is the language of the video. So all these small tags, all these small information that we can add to schema, and these information and these bits and pieces which you add to your JSON is being displayed over the video section inside the webmasters. So I hope you have got your answer. If not, please connect to me parallelly. I'll be happy to discuss over this. Next is from the Jazz Singh, how to make SEO better while you are using Punjabi language. So, Mr. Singh, I guess this is very much equivalent to what Udevani asked, like how can we improve our SEO if you are using any vernacular content. So, use schema.ld JSON. If you are not using AMP, please use AMP. In AMP, create schema.ld JSON data. Use your content as it is. In some keywords, if you see that those keywords are more populating inside English, use your English keywords there. Otherwise, Punjabi keywords are also fine. Use a description. In description, use LSI keywords in English if possible. Keep your URL structure in English if that's in Punjabi. So these are the baseline practices of which you can pick from English part. And based on what content you are writing, based on what keywords you see which are more useful, you can replace them via English. And again, it depends upon you on what user base you want to expand. You want to expand over user base which is mostly Punjabi speaking, then keep your in-language Punjabi. Otherwise, you can keep it English. If you are keeping that English, make sure that you add some English elements inside your content. But mostly, if you're having a Punjabi language website, you put Punjabi as an in-language there. There are lots of codes which are available for every language. You can pick those code and use that code inside JSON, LDJSON structure. So next question is again from Anjit Gohil, is how to solve AMP errors under Google Search Console. Sir, it's a very vast question. There are lots and lots of type of errors which we receive, and based on what kind of error we are receiving, we solve it accordingly. So for example, if it's an error that there is some non-AMP tag which is coming in the page due to some content or due to some media, so we have to convert that into AMP version of the article. So if you are facing some errors on this, I'll drop my email in the chat. Please mail me what kind of errors and what issues you are facing. Another is, does Google Discover support all languages like Punjabi, etc.? Yes, it supports all the vernacular language, all the vernacular language whose codes are there on their listing, whether it's Punjabi, Bengali, Kannada, Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, etc., whatever language which has been approved is all been supported by Google Discover. But you need to mention that language inside your schema JSON delta. One last question we are taking, after that we'll continue back to our slides. Udevani is again asking whether we have to write a small summary of Kannada news content in English in website pages so that it can rank high for a targeted keyword. Udevani team, this is not very much useful. So if I see the searcher of a website, and I've seen it before, below the title, you write three or four lines as a subtext or a summary of whatever article you're writing in. And you can do this experiment with the title of your page. In the schema data, you can use two kind of titles. One can be in Kannada, and you can separate them via pipe or a hyphen, and you can write down another title in English. And the title and the combination of title and keywords can be a A/B test for you. Writing whole summary down in English for Kannada can be a pain for your editors and for your content creators as well. And we can start very simply with the title, and please include don't use the same title in the article. In the article, please use Kannada title only. On the meta of the title, you can use Kannada plus English, and in the schema as well, you can use Kannada plus English, and keywords, again, a combination of both Kannada plus English. So no need to go ahead with the summary right now. You can start with the title and the keywords. You can run an A/B test, and you can see the differences between both. So in case you have any more queries, please write it down on the comments. I'll be more than happy to address at the end of the slide. And in case you want to discuss more, please connect to me on the parallel. We'll be discussing more on this. So now getting back to our slide, Google Discover, we have discussed mostly all the best practices, all the nitty-gritties which we can perform in our pages, and in which we can start experimenting, we can start A/B testing. But the major of all is that you should be using AMP pages if you want better performance of your site on Discover. I'm saying this from my personal experiences, that the website who are using AMP pages are most likely to get their Discover card made. It's not like that if you're not using AMP, your card will not be there in Discover. They will be. But if you're using AMP, there are lots and lots of features which you can leverage. Because first, AMP pages are way lighter than the mobile web pages. Their content is being cached on the Google site, so they open blazingly fast. The ads and revenue is comparatively higher than the normal pages. So if you're putting too much of hard work in writing their content and creating your website, please use AMP if you're not using. And the few slides which we will be discussing now is mostly centered around what are the good best practices which we can use in AMP pages, and how these best practices has helped us post our content get added inside the Google Discover. So baseline AMP practices include that whatever media formats or whatever AMP HTML formats which you are using inside your pages must be in AMP format. So this is the question which someone asked, Ms. Anirudh asked, I guess, in the chat, like how can we remove AMP errors. So mostly errors which we got in AMP are due to these small tags. AMP has a different set of tags than normal HTML, and sometimes when we convert a page into AMP HTML, these tags get unchanged, because every day new tags get introduced to the world. Till yesterday, till two weeks before, I was not able to see Instagram embeds inside the AMP. Now I see lots and lots of Instagram embeds inside the ads, Twitter embeds, and other embeds is also there. So new tags keep on coming, new iframe things keep on coming, new what we see as jugaads keep on coming, and we need to add these conversions inside our AMP pages so that the AMP HTML which we are using is seamless. And if our AMP pages are seamless, I'm damn sure that it will directly help us in all the matrices, whether it's Discover, whether it's organic, and last but not the least, on the revenue part. Second baseline AMP practice is make sure that your canonical and AMP HTML and alternate linking is there on the page. If you are generating it via plugin, then these things are already taken care of. But in case you want to have a recheck, please go and see your page. On AMP page, there must be a canonical tag. On canonical page, there must be an AMP HTML tag. So these are best practices. Second is ad format. So I'm pretty sure if you're using AMP, you must be monetizing them. Use most engaging ad formats inside your AMP pages. There are amazing ad formats which we have discovered and we have started using it inside our AMP pages thanks to our DBS product. And there are other formats as well which are ready-made, like for example, AMP Flying Carpet. Flying Carpet is another interactive format. You can place it in between your two or three paragraph or first or second paragraph of your content. And it's a parallax type of ad. It itself brings too much engagement to the pages. Fourth is analytical measurements. Please measure whatever sections and whatever small snippets you are adding inside your AMP pages. If you are adding a video format or a YouTube video or an AMP video, place analytics over it, see how many people are playing that. If people are not playing that, remove that so that a page can get a little bit lighter. See what extra elements are present on your page. Generate a heat map of your page and measure different things like how is the performance of your normal website and comparison to your AMP pages. Compare them on the revenue sites as well, because there you can see the real difference. Now, design strategies is one of the part which I cannot ignore. So my coordinator told me that please try to keep the deck short, but there was lots of information I want to share with all of you, and I cannot ignore design. That's my favorite topic. So these are the few design strategies which are very universal and which we have seen have proved most impressive. And they have given us amazing results. And those are very basic. And I'm pretty sure most of them are following, most of you are following them. But in case you don't, please have a look. So please make sure that whenever you are designing your AMP page, it should be very similar, or it should be exactly similar to your normal web page. So that the user which is coming to your website, he or she should not be able to see or differentiate that whether he is landing on an AMP page or on a normal web page. Increase your branding visibility on the top. Use big and bold logo inside your header or whatever design structure you follow over there. Use your branding with a swag, actually. Use a branding with a swag. So this is a new WhatsApp status, I guess I will put on. So use a brand like a swag. Place your logo boldly and beautifully on the header, because you are doing a lot of work to deliver that content to the user. So why not swag it? And another technical reason why you should be doing this is because if a user is landing on your page, he's seeing your content on the page, and if your page is already there inside his discover interest list, that means he's your targeted audience, right? So he or the person should be, or the user should be aware of what brand you are, so that he will keep that in mind. A brand logo or a logo stays in mind way longer than the content. So next time he will see your card, he will be prompted to click on that, see the news, because he knew that the user knew that this particular brand serves good content, or the content which is relevant to me. And it directly increases your brand visibility. People will start associating to your brands. They will search out for you on other platforms as well. They will search out to you organically. They will search out to you on Twitter, Facebook, Insta, or all these third-party platforms. So again, you are building a returning user base. And if your design and the branding is very smart, you're generating more engagement. User will be seeing other parts of your pages as well. Or if he's landing on the article page, he might want to visit homepage as well, because he see that the particular content is very much useful to me. And in this, we can also add a slide which we discussed earlier, that add to home screen and service worker to your pages. To your structure, so that if someone is liking your site, you can prompt them with a add to home screen button, and boom, you have got a stable and always returning user. And once the add to home screen is done, when the service worker is done, you can start sending him push notification. More and more engagement has been done, more and more interest building gets to that. So it's very exponential. The small steps leads to exponential growth via branding. Next is sticky plus next. So lots of AMP pages which I see across, and AMP sticky has been amazing form of revenue generation. And thanks a lot to Google and AMP team that they have released this ad format from their side only, because earlier a publisher used to struggle with small JavaScript codes and small div codes where they have to hide and they have to write a function to close the event. Sometimes they just hide the ad and the calls are going in the background, and they must be receiving these errors from ad servers. So now when this sticky has been made all these things has been taken care of. You just have to add an AMP sticky, and in that AMP sticky, you can write down your AMP code. Now, with the placement of AMP sticky on the bottom, we have lost, not lost actually, we earlier think we lost our placement of next news. Usually, we populate the next news, and after the user reads 30 or 40% of the page, or 50% of the page, we give them the next news. So, for example, I'm reading a news about that so many cases of coronavirus has been detected in India. And when the user reads 30-40%, we populate the next news. So, this has been the overall number of the world till now. So, it's a multi-story. It becomes a multi-thread format of the story. So, for that, we have came up with designs with sticky plus next. So, a small sticky is always coming on the bottom with a cross button. Below that, on a material design layout, we have created this sticky next where you can populate the next news. And this format is broadly available on lots of websites which we power of the AMP, their AMP we power. You can see this sticky next is available there. And because it comes from the bottom, it is very visible to the user. And with the help of this small sticky next pop-up, we are getting better viewability because people are sticking on the pages. They are viewing two pages rather than one. More clicks are happening on the page, so more engagement is happening on the page, and higher CPMs are there because the ad AMP sticky is there, so it gets refreshed every 30 seconds. So more CPMs get generated. So These two best practices help us directly with two things. First, it helps us to build our brand, increase our traffic. Plus, the engagement which is happening due to these factors on the pages will help us or help our pages to get into Google Discover. Now, what are the exclusive features which we have added to AMP? And I was really excited to show to all of you. Share some results which we got around that. So we initially added the support of AMP Live Blog inside our AMP generating platform. And if you are not using our AMP generating platform, this AMP Live Blog documentation is available on AMP.dev. And you can also add this feature inside your AMP pages. So AMP Live Blog is very similar to a live blog which people usually run for any matches or for any events. The only difference is it is in AMP format, so it's more lighter and more easily available and cached on the Google side, and it is very light and simple and very very interactive to the users. This is a simple timeline format which we designed, and whenever new update come, you don't have to refresh the page. There's a small pop-up which come on the top saying you have updates, and you click on them, the latest update gets loaded. And one of the best feature of this is AMP. So this will come above all other parallel pages which are not AMP, and although those are live blogs. Next is AMP Stories. I'm pretty sure most of you are aware of this, and if you are not, please explore something about AMP Stories. This is a very beautiful format, and I personally feel that this is a transformation of the web. So Ishita in her first slide told that it's not just feeds now. People are evolving, web is evolving, and I guess AMP Stories is one of the biggest leap which we have gotten out there. And that too on an AMP format. So AMP Stories is very much similar to WhatsApp Stories and Instagram Stories, but those are on AMP and those are on web. So they are easily discoverable to everyone. You can search for a particular topic and you can land an AMP story. You can learn about something in just few clicks, tap, 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 which we usually do on our WhatsApps and Instagram. I do it daily. Again, very interactive format. It will help you to get low bounce rate because, a whole article is covered in just 5-6 slides, and that too with beautiful images and beautiful format and user experience. Second, it's very interactive. Every time you have to tap and you have to go to the next slide, you have to tap on the page, right? And you have to tap on view more, or you have to tap on different tags or actions which are CTAs which are available on the page. So you are generating engagement on your page, and that was a prime concern. Apart from that, there are new innovative formats of monetization. You can add new ads in between the slides. Those are full page ads. It increases your user retention because, you know, in the last slide of the AMP story, in the last story of the AMP story, you can see you can add links to other stories. So, for example, if I am searching about some amazing buildings in Delhi, in the end, you can add, for example, I'm saying, you can add, see these beautiful pictures of Taj Mahal or beautiful pictures of Lotus Temple, anything. So, if a user is coming to your page, you are directly transforming that one user page per view to n number of pages per user. So, again, innovative, provides you more monetization, multi-thread, and you are engaging your user a lot. So there is a hell lot of chances that these pages will get added to your Google Discover interest list. Again, the new feature, it is still in development mode, but a stable version is all out, is AMP next page. So I am pretty sure that everybody here is aware of how infinite scroll on a normal website works. You read a whole article, below that we populate the next article, and it automatically gets appended in the page. Now, this all has been happening in non-AMP pages via JavaScript, but on AMP page, we have this restriction that we cannot use normal JavaScript. So, AMP team has come up with AMP next page. This is very, 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 very easy to implement. All the websites which are on our platform are already using that and leveraging benefits out of it, but in case you are using any third-party platforms or any other CMSs, it can be easily added to AMP. You have to pass a JSON, and in that JSON you have to add two more articles you have. There's a limit of three in this AMP next module. So you can just pass a JSON what two more articles you want to add. You just have to give the URLs, and based on that, those two articles will be added below. And one more amazing feature in AMP Next is it adds the article based on interest and based on the internet connection. So if the internet connection is bad, it will not add those two articles. It will just display the links of those articles. And in case if the internet connection is good, it will automatically add that. AMP Next has been very useful on AMP pages, and it has been amazing if the traffic is coming via Discover, because a user is coming to read one page and we are displaying him, we are suggesting him two more pages, and we have seen the average page per view per user is 2.5 since we have enabled this for few publishers. So we have just converted one page per user to 2.5 pages per user by using AMP Next page, whether they are coming from Discover. When they come from Discover, there are lots of extra addition which gets added to it. The ad CPMs are better. If it's coming from organic search, again, ad CPMs are better. Engagement is better. So that way, this small feature has helped us to grow our traffic exponentially, and without too much of promotion, but with the help of tech. From the tech side, we are just adding, we are trying to add too much value to our solution. Next is video formats. So there are lots of publishers who are there on the call as well. They must be using lots and lots of videos inside their AMP pages. New ad video formats has been added inside AMP support. You can use AMP video, you can use AMP YouTube, you can use JW Player is again one of the most used players in lots of platforms. So do try these videos, do try this video formats, and leverage the richness of the page. A few discussions, I'll be just quickly wrapping up the slides because we have got some questions coming in, and I don't want to take too much of your time. I'm pretty sure everybody wants to have an evening tea. So I just wrap up quickly. So a few ad suggestions I wanted to add. Whenever you're using AMP pages, please place your ads if you're coming on the first call of your page, nearby the images. So if you're using a featured image, please place an ad tag in the first scroll above or below the image, mostly below the image. So that way, people who are, the user who are landing on a page is very much, interested in the featured image, because that's how he's coming to the page. In Discover case, he saw the image, he saw a beautiful card, he landed on the page. So ad, or place an ad around the image, below the image, so that the viewability of the particular ad will increase. In content ad, again, you can use various innovative formats which are there in AMP ads bouquet. I have seen most of the publishers who are using AMP ads, AMP pages are not able to insert the ad in between the article because of the JavaScript dependency. But there are lots of modules which are available on the NPM part. There are lots of modules are available on the WordPress as well. And if you are using our platform, then it's automatically embedded. But in case if you are finding any issues in that, please write to us and we'll absolutely help you to add more and more better ad placements inside your AMP pages. There's no dependency of JavaScript on this. We have found out different and various methods so that we can add these advertisements in between the content. Again, it helps us with the better viewability, better engagement with the ad, and if you're using better ad formats, again, it's a cherry on the top. Also, place some ad formats in the unexplored sections. If the height of your content is not more than 3 or 4 paragraphs, add a read more section below your article, and I'm pretty sure all of you have that. If not, please do add that and try to monetize that. Place small ads, if not 300 by 250, then 320 by 50 ads in between the listing items. There are lots of listing item ads available on AdSense, and those all are AMP compatible. That's the gist of all the PPT, all the session which we have covered in last few slides. I hope you find it useful, and I hope you start using all these best practices in your website. And I'm looking forward to see beautiful AMP pages, beautiful AMP stories on the live mobile web pretty soon. And I will be amazed if I see all these publishers who are here, and those pages are coming up in my Discover searches. So last but not the least, we are from Team Readwhere. So Readwhere has a product called Readwhere CMS. Readwhere CMS is not for content management system. It's for complete mobile solutions. We provide complete mobile solutions starting from AMP, PWA, and apps. And we help with engagement and monetization of news and media publishers on videos, and lots of services around that. These are my credentials. If you want, you can reach me directly on mobi.readwhere.com. My email ID is over there. You can reach me out. You can connect me on Twitter from here. In case you want to see what more updates we are doing on our AMP project and on our CMS part, you can follow me on Git on Vaibhav-Readwhere. Thank you. Thank you very much. So now I guess we have some time for the questions. I'll one by one take the questions. So one more question is coming in is, how to know that my competitors are doing differently for targeted keywords? Whether any tool is there to check for free? Team Udemani, I'm not sure about that. Like how you can check your target or your parallel customers who are doing or using the same keywords or content which are using. I guess they can be some tools. I'll be doing some research over it and surely connect to you and come up with the tools. But one thing that we can make sure is that whatever richness we as a brand can bring to our platform, that is unique. So more uniqueness to the content and more uniqueness to the pages is always a contribution to a better web world. So I'll get back to you on if there are any tools available like this. But in case you want to see, you can see that manually. And you know, Google Trends can help you with all the trends coming in and coming up around your content you want to write. So a couple of more questions, I guess we can take. So one question we have got from Rajesh is how to implement AMP next page on AMP website. So Rajesh, AMP on, you can go to amp.dev and there are lots of documentation available on amp.dev where you can add this AMP next version or AMP next module inside your AMP pages. There are lots of, if you're using WordPress, in WordPress plugins as well, there's customization where you can enable this. Please mention your email ID or, you know, send us your email ID on support@rwdx.com. We'll help you with all the documentation. And if possible, if you're using WordPress, we can help you directly with the plugins. And if you're using custom CMS, we can help you directly with the solution. So I guess we have mostly taken all of the questions. In case someone has anything more related to ask to me, please connect me over all these credentials. I'm highly active on Twitter, so don't judge me on that. You can reach me out there, or you can I'll drop my email ID on the chat. You can pick my email ID from there. Or you can visit us at rwadx.com, where you'll get all the necessary information. So one more, a few questions we are getting in. Sorry, I'm delaying it a little bit. So one more question we have got from Bangla Hunt is, how to solve error on Search Console? If I can't able to solve the issue, can I delete that page? So Bangla Hunt, I won't advise you to delete that page because there are lots of you know, work that has gone behind that web, that, you know, publishing that web page. I'm pretty sure your content creators had put in a lot of hard work to create that page. And in case you are not able to solve an error, please don't delete that. Try to debug the page. Try to debug the page step by step and see on what module you are giving that particular error. If possible, try deleting some part of your content in which that particular error is coming, or if the error is coming due to any media format like video or any embed, please try removing that embed and add the correct version of that embed inside the page. And in case there is no choice, then you can delete the page. But before that, we are the one, we can help you. So you can reach out to us and we can help you with the debugging of the page. We have a separate team. We have a support team dedicated to, support publishers on all these small issues. One last question, which we'll be taking up today, and I hope everybody is ready for the tea of the evening, is on 1 month of high traffic by Discover and following month the 50% dip. What do we need to check to address the issue? So Vignesh, it's a very broad topic, I can say. The dip can be because of anything in last month, in the starting of this year, we have got a change inside Discover preferences. There are updates which keep on coming, like every now and then Google Search API gets updated, Google Discover APIs also gets updated. And based on those updates, we have to make certain changes inside our pages. So it's a never-ending process, actually. And that's why we have to keep an eye on both of the parts. We have to keep an eye on what updates and on what few things this Google Discover is publishing. You can follow all these things on web.dev. So this is a new platform where all these new updates is coming. You can subscribe to Google's newsletters where you can able to see what all updates are happening on different APIs. on a different side, we have built our platform like this only. We don't want you publishers to, you know, get into too much of the tech, and you know, you keep focus on the content. We'll handle the tech part for you. So, thank you guys. Thank you again. Thank you for joining me. These are very hard times for all of us. Please stay home, stay safe. Thank you.